presentation, based on the presentation that I've done before, and this presentation was in Dutch, so today I will also teach you some Dutch words, because the words in the presentation will be in Dutch, but there will be a lot of pictures. Edward already asked me just a minute ago, Raymond, should I know this picture? And this is a question I raise to you. Alex, you know this tower?
But is it the old Olympic Tower?
Yeah, it is. It is called the Marathon Tower in Amsterdam. And in fact, it's a very, you know, the Olympic Games are full of symbols and symbolism. And this was the first Olympic Games in 1928 that the Olympic fire was there for the whole, then it was in 3 weeks, I think it was 10 days then at the time. And it was in the stadium. The torch relay, you know the torch relay, yeah? With the, nowadays they have a whole tour through the world. The torch relay is from 1936. It was Hitler's idea to do that. But the Marathon Tower in Amsterdam, it was the first Olympic Games, and the stadium is still there, huh? in Amsterdam. And what you also see, of course, is the logo of the Olympic Games, the Olympic circles. And I think you know that each circle represents, what? Represent something,
continent.
A continent, of course. But this is the easy question. But now the trivial pursuit question. What do the colors represent? We know of the logo. Jaco, what do the colors represent? We know this logo. You know, it's together with McDonald's is the most the M. It's these are the two most famous logos in the world. Huh? So everybody in the world knows this logo. But the colors, Emma, do you know what the colors represent? Some people say, well, each color represents a continent, blue for Europe, yellow for Asia, but that's not true. It's every flag in the world has at least one of these colors.
Oh.
Yeah. Second lesson learned of today, okay. So, Olympic Games in the Netherlands. Why am I studying this topic? Both from a professional point of view and a personal point of view. Let's start with the personal point of view.
Yeah.
That's nice, right? I was at the Olympics in 2004. Is that me? Yeah, that's me, all of them. And I was invited to go there with a Dutch company because I'm a gymnast. I'm coaching gymnastics, and I was there for let's say 6 weeks, 5.5 weeks. But in 2004, this was also the moment professionally in the Netherlands when it was addressed by many people. Well. If Greece can organize such an event, we as Holland should be able to do so too. Greece is such a chaotic country, only 11 million people, and we as a planning country and with 16, 17 million people, we should be able to do so. So 2004 is a moment, not only because of the Olympics in Athens, but also in the societal and professional debate about, organizing Olympic Games in the Netherlands. So from that moment on, this is a document by the Dutch Olympic Committee, NOC-NSF. They started to think about organizing Olympic Games in the Netherlands. And July in 2006, this document was published, I think, if you remember? I think in 2006. It's called A Dream in Three Parts, Start, Olympic Games 2028. And what does it say? It's the ambition of the Dutch Olympic Committee to think about and to actually increase and improve the conditions in the Netherlands for sports. So in the national documents, policy documents, it is said that the Netherlands need to be want to be a top 10 sports country in the world. That means on all kinds of sports you want to be in the top level. And that for doing so, it is said in this document, we have three stages to go to. First of all, to a good piece of research on what is needed to reach that top 10 ambition. And second step is, okay, what kind of facilities, events do we really have to make, to create, to develop? And as a third stage, perhaps bid for an Olympic game in 2028. And this date, 2028, is also a symbolic date. It could be another date, but it's 100 years after Amsterdam 1928. in the last summer, when there were the Olympics in Beijing, there was a big exhibition in the NIE, National Architecture Institute in Rotterdam, about Olympics. And one of my students, former students, Dirk Verhagen, who contributed to some of the making of the posters over there. It was not only in the professional debate, but also it's also a society debate. The pers, you know, the pers, this new small newspaper that you can read in the train, if you can read Dutch. Yeah. In 2007 they made a nice picture. It was also in the going towards the Olympics of Beijing. They made this, I think, very nice drawing in the newspaper to show a little bit about the spatial conditions in the Netherlands with respect to sports. So if you take, for example, the south of the Netherlands, South Limburg, the province, it's well known for cycling. So you see here the pump for your bike, right? And the city of Eindhoven is well known for its swimming culture. And here the beaches in Zeeland for volleyball. And here, well, you know her perhaps, it's the chairwoman of the Dutch Olympic Committee. She comes from the Achterhoek. The region over there in the Netherlands.
Is it Erika Terpstra?
Erika Terpstra, yeah, correct. So here the rowing, and here of course the represents the Feyenoord football stadium, water sport, sand sport, well, very traditional.
Horse swimming?
Very traditional.
Dutch
sports. Here our prince for shooting. How is it? Is it shooting?
Hunting.
Hunting. Yeah, but shooting is also in the sports in the Olympics, the athletic stadium over here. So this was indeed a very, I think, nice drawing. It shows some of the, where, well, it illustrates the spatial conditions or the location in the Netherlands, which is an identity, identiteitsdrager, a place that carries the identity of certain sports. And of course, this represents Amsterdam because Amsterdam is, whenever, I think, we are going to organize Olympic Games, we should use the trademark of Amsterdam. That's world known. And another question for you. When the Dutch Olympic Committee presented their ambitions and their for this plan, it was the Ministry of Spatial Planning who first adopted the idea and organized all kinds of workshops. I will talk about some of the results of that, and it's in fact these books. It was the Ministry of Spatial Planning that adopted the idea of the NOC NSF first. It was not the Ministry of Sports, not the Ministry of Economics, not the Ministry of Transport, but Spatial Planning. Do you have any idea why the Ministry of Spatial Planning...
When is this?
It was... So the plan was presented in 2006 and 2007. The Ministry of Spatial Planning translated in all kinds of workshops. At the end of 07 and the beginning of 08, we did these workshops.